Welcome all, it's Russ. And in this video, we're gonna talk about more advanced ranges and more advanced slices. So I've already shown you in a for loop that we can say for I in range 100. And what this will do is it will loop over, it'll set I for all the values from 0 to 99. So this 100, it's an exclusive upper bound. Now, sometimes you don't want to start at 0. So it is permissible to start at some other value, -13, 100. What will that do? Well, it will first have -13, then -12, then -10, -11, all the way up to 0, and then we'll count up 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 99. So again, what we have here, if you pass two parameters to range, then what you have is two bounds. You have an inclusive lower bound. This is going to sound really familiar. And it's going to have an exclusive upper bound. So that is working basically the same way as the bounds on a slice worked. That you have two numbers, the start and the end. The start is inclusive and the end is exclusive. Now, there is yet another form of range. And you could add what's called a step value. So let's add a step value of 3. Now what this step value is it's telling you how much you should advance every time. So let's go ahead and we'll put in print I. We know that on the first iteration of the loop, it would do -13. But it doesn't go to -12. Instead, what it's going to do is it's going to add 3 to the value. So after -13, it's then -10. Then it is -7, -4, -1. It of course then goes 2, 5, 8, and so on. So this will go all the way up until it eventually hits 98. Now, this step value doesn't change how we evaluate the upper bound. Basically, the step value, it changes how much we jump, but our condition is keep looping so long as the value is less than or equal to this. So 98, it definitely ran. But our next one after that would be 101. Since that's greater than 100, since it's greater than or equal to 100, then our loop ends at 98. We don't print anything after 98. So we have three forms of range now. We have a range with a single variable, in which case it is the upper bound. This pen's starting to die as well. We have range with two parameters. That is a lower bound and an upper bound. If range has three parameters, then it is the lower bound, the upper bound, and the step value. Is there anything else that's interesting that you can do? Well, you could make the step value negative. That is allowed. It makes it a little weird to think about what these two bounds mean, but we'll show you how this works. So if this was -1, for instance, this means that every time we go through the loop, we're going to decrement our value instead of increment it. So in this case, what we'll do, let's just imagine we put in 100 and zero here. In this case, what you're gonna realize is that calling it the lower bound isn't precisely correct. It's better to think of this as the start point. All right, so if we start at 100, then it will do a loop at 100, then it will go down by 1, 99, then it goes down by 1, 98, 97. Now, what happens when we start to get low? We've got 4, 3, 2, 1. When it, I'm sorry that this is, these pens are going crazy. 4, 3, 2, and 1. So it has counted down to this point. 0 is the stop point. And we don't actually run 0. So this will actually end after hitting number 1. So you'll notice that when we had, if we had range 0, 100, 1, then it would go from 0 to 99. If we have 100, 0, negative 1, it starts at 100, it never reaches 0. How could we change this to make it 0 to 99? We change this to 99, we change this to negative 1. And then it would never run the 100 loop, and it would run a zero loop at the bottom. All right, so now you can do range with three different forms, including the possibility of doing negative. That's pretty cool. But remember that we said that this reminded us of slicing. Is it possible to do slicing with three parameters? Absolutely. And it works exactly the same way. Don't use this black. Got to refill that pen. X equals 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Y equals X. Slice from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, we'll slice to 5, colon 2. Remember, what does this mean? This is the lower bound, or if you prefer, you could think of it as the start point. This is the upper bound. It's exclusive. This is the stop point. This is how much. All right, we go, we read. What are we going to get? We're going to get a new array that has the value 20, that's position 1. Then it's going to hop ahead by 2 steps. It's going to get the value 40, that was at index 3. But wait, we're not supposed to get to index 5. So what does this slice do? This starts at 1, ends before we get to 5, jumps by 2. So it pulls out elements 1 and elements 3 out of the array. Elements 1 and 3 get copied down. All right. So that is more advanced ranges, more advanced slices. Hope you found that interesting. Hope you found it useful. I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.